So, as you are making healthier choices and starting to change over to healthier foods, we might start getting into that frame of mind that like, oh, I can't eat those foods because they're bad. And once we start doing this, once we start restricting ourselves, oh, I can't have cookie, I can't have cake. Well, then what happens? It's like your brain hyper focuses on it. Oh, I can't have this thing. And then we start setting up this kind of feeling of deprivation. I feel deprived. And then our brain hyper focuses on it and it's all we can think about. Oh, cookies or whatever that is, the cake or even the drink of alcohol. Our mind starts really focusing. And then we start creating almost this inner conflict or war with ourselves over what we can have and what we can't have. So a good way to get rid of this idea, and once again, we're really looking for a balance with our food, our body, and our fitness. So a good way to stay away from this idea of deprivation and that it's a recipe for cravings. Once you're told you can't have something, that's the only thing you can think about. So you can curtail this by setting up an anything goes day. Have one day a week that you eat whatever you want. And don't worry too much about whether it's a good food or a bad food, but you'll start to pay attention to your body and how it feels for your body. There's some foods that I used to really like. I just don't eat them anymore because I'm recognizing how my body feels after eating those foods. So as you clean up your diet through the week, having that one anything goes day, maybe it's on the weekend because that's when friends and family like to go out on the town more. But once you have that anything goes day, something else happens. We start prioritizing our treats. I'm gonna skip this candy bar because it's only so-so, but I'm really gonna kind of focus on the things that I really like, cheesecake. You know, that is my thing. I love cheesecake. And if I skip the candy bar, I'm making a choice in my mind that I'm skipping kind of these low-level things that we take for granted or don't notice for some of those higher, more extravagant indulgences that we really enjoy. So it's even better to really enjoy your food rather than, you know, going into that cycle of guilt or criticism. So we can curtail that, the guilt, the criticism, by just having an anything goes day. Don't even call it a cheat day because it still sounds like we're doing something bad, right? So anything goes day, put it on your calendar, and then notice how your mind starts prioritizing. So maybe you're not going to have a piece of cake every night after dinner, which, you know, I grew up in a meat and potatoes house and my mom was a home ec major. So yes, we had sweets every meal. Wasn't until I got out of that family system that I recognized not everybody eats like that. So get yourself to stabilizing with healthy choices through the week and then have your anything goes day. And you'll be paying attention to your body and how it feels. And then from there, you'll start making, naturally making those healthier and healthier choices. And it also curtails that deprivation and I can't have it, but I'm going to have it. It kind of curtails that response as well. So pick your day for anything goes and start to notice how you're thinking and feeling about foods as you're finding and changing over to healthier choices. Here's to your health, happiness, and success, and I'll see you next time.